If you are interested in learning about a legendary jazz musician whose playing and singing style were a major influence on other musicians and singers in the genre and beyond, my Louis Armstrong Later Life Black History Short is for you. If you haven't checked out my Black History Short about his early life, I'd recommend you start with that episode first and then come back to this one. Hi, and thank you for tuning in to Noir Histoire. I'm Natasha, and in this episode, I'll be sharing what I've learned about Louis Armstrong. Born on August 4th, 1901, died on July 6, 1971. Notable musician, nationality, American. Despite his popularity in the 1920s, Louis Armstrong struggled to find work during the Great Depression, which prompted a move to Los Angeles, where he continued to work as a musician, but also made his movie debut playing himself. But his time in LA was cut short following an arrest and conviction for possession of marijuana. He got off rather lightly with a suspended sentence, which allowed him to return to Chicago. Over the years, Armstrong would appear in several other films, becoming the first Black American to star in a Hollywood film. With Armstrong frequently moving around the country, while his wife, Lil, chose to remain in Chicago, their marriage fell apart, though they didn't divorce until 1938. During that same year, Armstrong married his girlfriend of several years, Alpha Smith. But 4 years later, that marriage also ended in divorce, after which Armstrong married his fourth and final wife, whom he'd begun dating shortly after his marriage to his third wife. Messy. Armstrong toured America and Europe extensively, beginning in the 1920s, which continued well into the 1940s. He performed as part of and later became the leader of big bands until they declined in popularity. In the late 1940s, Armstrong scaled back and put together Louis Armstrong and the All-Stars, a six-piece ensemble that primarily focused on New Orleans-style jazz. During the 1930s, when Armstrong's profile was soaring, he'd been held in high regard by musicians who admired his experimental and energetic playing style. But critics gave negative reviews of his music and performances, which they viewed through an often racist lens as being too untamed. Yet, as new jazz styles and musicians emerged, at the same time Armstrong was returning to more traditional forms, he came to be regarded as stagnant and stale. His permanent grin and onstage demeanor, combined with avoiding discussions or comments on racism, led to some referring to him as an out-of-touch Uncle Tom. Ironically, during this period, Armstrong received positive reviews in the media. Publicly, he took the negativity in stride, as he saw himself as an entertainer and his stage persona as part of the performance. Things came to a head in 1957 while Armstrong and his ensemble were on a tour on behalf of the U.S. State Department. Armstrong and other musicians were being used to generate positive press for America abroad, particularly in communist countries. It was a blatant PR move that misrepresented the reality of America's many internal problems, especially with regards to race. But back in Arkansas, the Little Rock Nine saga was unfolding. Black students were attempting to integrate a high school in the face of threatening local opposition, segregationist state government, and indifferent federal government. Angered by the events in Little Rock, Armstrong canceled the Soviet Union leg of the tour and returned to America. Back in the States, Armstrong finally spoke out against racial discrimination by sharing some of his own experiences in the South, voicing his support for the Little Rock Nine, and calling out President Eisenhower and the governor of Arkansas. The backlash was swift, though short-lived. His songs were pulled by radio stations, and some other Black entertainers abandoned him in fear that he was being too direct and would negatively affect Black people. This was another instance in a pattern throughout Armstrong's career of being alternatingly viewed as doing too much or not doing enough. Things died down when the National Guard was sent to provide a safe escort for the Little Rock Nine, which some felt finally happened in part because of Armstrong's public criticisms. While on tour in 1959, Armstrong suffered a heart attack in Italy, which forced him to temporarily take a break from his demanding schedule. Still in need of rest, he resumed performing a few weeks later, ignoring advice from his doctors. In 1960, he went on a three-month tour of Africa that was organized by the U.S. State Department. His heart issues continued, and he developed kidney complications during the late 1960s, which once again forced him to take a break. He returned to performing in 1970, but suffered a second heart attack in early 1971. After only 2 months of rest, he was able to practice and play, but wasn't yet strong enough to tour or perform. The day for a return to public performances never came, as he passed away at the home he had shared with his wife since 1943 in Queens, New York, on July 6, 1971. Following his death, Armstrong's body lay in state and was viewed by tens of thousands of people, with the funeral being broadcast across the country. His legacy included amazing performances that wielded tremendous influence in music. He is also notable for being the oldest American musician to have a number one song with his release of Hello Dolly in 1963, which knocked the Beatles out of the top spot. What a Wonderful World had been recorded in 1967 and was an international hit, but bombed in America due to poor promotion. It became one of his signature songs when it was re-released 16 years after his death. Thanks for tuning in. Show notes and sources are available on the Noir Histoire website via the link in the episode description. I'm working on creating downloadables and infographics, so keep an eye on the website. These Black History Shorts are released every Tuesday, so if you enjoyed this episode and want more, subscribe to the channel, click the notification bell, and check out my Black History Shorts playlist.